All right, you recognize any of these guests today? Some of you?
Yeah.
Well, welcome. Welcome, families. Yes, you too. Mr. Richards is here as well. Hi, you must be Kyle's sister, right? Yes, I can tell. I can tell you look like your big brother. Well, welcome. I'm glad you all could make it today. I know it's not easy coming in the middle of the day, the middle of a work day to be here, but trust me when I say they're so happy that you're here, and so am I. The kids, it just took a few extra minutes to get settled. They're just very, it's electric in here. So let me give you a little bit of background about what they've been working on and what they're going to present for you today. So over the last couple of weeks, they've been diving into this Twilight Zone episode. You heard of the Twilight Zone? It's called The Monsters Are Due on Maple Street. And it's all about this street, Maple Street, that could be any town, anywhere. And come on in. Hi there, welcome. Anywhere where there's a seat. And one night, one special night, they see this light go across the sky. And when that happens, these strange things start happening in the night, right? Several strange things. And then the night just gets even weirder. And the behavior gets odd, and it snowballs. And so today, in this trial, we have the prosecution right here. They are trying to prove that the people on this street were the true monsters. They behaved in such a way that you would consider them being monsters. Back here, the defense, they're defending the people on Maple Street, and they're going to argue that these people aren't monsters. They behaved in a way that they were just trying to protect one another. And then right here in the front, we have the jury, and of course, their job today is to take all of this information, all of this evidence, and make the decision. Are the people of Maple Street guilty or not guilty of being the monsters? So, I just want to reiterate, I've been trying to not be emotional today because I'm so proud of these kids. So first of all, this type of event, they've never done before. They've never had a mock trial before. And then you throw into the mix that I've said, well, you need to get up in front of everyone. You need to project your voice, eye contact, and then, like, the biggest thing of all, dress nice for one day. You know, like, come to school dressed up, and they're, like, horrified. But they did it. And so we practiced and practiced and practiced, and they are ready. You're ready, right? Well, it's the time. Okay?
Well, at least they're honest.
Yeah, they're excited. So what we're going to do first, before we jump into the trial itself, the jury, they have been researching all week about what it is to be on a jury, what that is, what the job is, how do you get on a jury. So one by one, they're going to come up front and give you a little bit of an education, and then we'll start with the trial, okay? Just like we practiced. All right, so let's get started.
The definition of jury is a body of people sworn to give a verdict in a legal case on the basis of evidence submitted to them in the court.
All
Judicial Circuit. Criminal Division is now in session. The Honorable Judge Mrs. Cook presiding.
Everyone but the jury may be seated. Mrs. Malott, please swear in the jury.
Please raise your right hand. Do you solemnly swear that you will truly listen to this case and render a true verdict and a fair sentence to this defendant? If so, your answer is I do.
I do.
Members of the jury, your duty today will be to determine whether the defendant is guilty or not guilty based on facts and evidence provided in this case. The prosecution must prove that a crime was committed and that the defendant is the person who committed the crime. However, if you are not satisfied of the defendant's guilt, then reasonable doubt exists and the defendant must be found not guilty. Mrs. Malott, what is today's case?
Your Honor, today's case is the State of Ohio versus the people of Naples.
Is the prosecution ready?
Yes, Your Honor.
Is the defense ready?
Yes, Your Honor.
To begin, prosecution, you may present your opening statement.
Shot a man. Also, Steve argues and accuses so many people. Please find the people of Maple Tree guilty of being the real monsters. Thank you.
Next, the defense. Please present your opening statements. You may present your claim and first premise. The defense may present their claim and first premise.
Thank you, Your Honor. First of all, Charlie shot Pete because he could not see. This was life or death. He had to make a choice. Charlie claims, "I was just trying to protect my family, that's all." It was very dark. Charlie could not see Pete. Charlie said he thought Pete was an alien. This evidence proved that Charlie is innocent. Charlie is just a man that was trying to protect his home and family. Thank you, Your Honor.
Prosecution, you may present your claim and second premise.
Thank you, Your Honor. Second of all, Les Goodman is one of the monsters because he is the only one to have a working car or anything working.
According to the text on page 7, man 1 says his car started. Somehow, his car started. Lastly, this proves that he is a monster.
The defense may may present their claim and second premise. Prosecution may present their first rebuttal.
Thank you, Your Honor. The defense has tried to convince you that Charlie shot an unknown figure to protect the street. However, this isn't right. What Charlie did was kill an innocent man. Thank you.
The defense may present their first rebuttal. Prosecution may present their second rebuttal.
The defense has tried to convince you that Steve, who was scared and wanted to know who the monster was.
However, this isn't right. What Steve did was accuse him.
You may present your second rebuttal.
Thank you, Your Honor. The prosecution thinks that Les Goodman is a monster because every night he goes outside and stays up in the sky looking for something. But this is false. Les Goodman has a sleeping disorder called insomnia and goes outside to relax and loves to stargaze. Thank you.
Both the prosecution and the defense have now rested their cases. The attorneys will now present their final arguments. Prosecution, you may begin.
Thank you, Your Honor. Members of the jury, today you have heard the testimony about the people of Main Street. I'd like to remind you of some important information that you consider in your decision. These facts include all the evidence proves that the humans really are monsters. For instance, Charlie shot Pete Van Horn without a second thought, and also Steve was trying to accuse people and arguing without any proof. So in the story, the humans really are monsters and the monsters of Maple Street. Please find the defendant, Steve and Charlie, guilty of being the real monsters of Maple Street. Thank you, Your Honor.
Defense, you may proceed with your closing argument.
Thank you, Your Honor. Members of the jury, today you have heard testimony about the people of Maple Street. I would like to remind you of some important information that you should consider in your decision. These facts include Charlie shot Pete because he was trying to protect his family at home.
Les Goodman keeps looking at the sky at night because he has insomnia, so he can't sleep. These actions are showing that people are just looking out for each other. Please find the defendant, Les Goodman and Charlie, not guilty of being an alien. Thank you.
Members of the jury, you have heard all of the testimony concerning this case. It is now up to you to determine the fact. You and you alone are the judges of the fact. Once you decide what facts the evidence presented proves, you must then make a final decision if the defendant is guilty or not guilty of the accused crime. In just a moment, the bailiff will take you to the jury room to consider your verdict. one of the first things you want to do is select a foreperson. It will be the foreperson's duty to sign the verdict form when a verdict has been agreed upon. Whatever verdict is made must be unanimous, which means that each and every person must agree on the same verdict. The bailiff will now escort you to the deliberation room. All rise. I'd like to know who you belong to in this group of kids. I think I could guess a few, but if you could just tell me which person is your child, grandchild, that would be great. All right, back here.
I'm Farrah.
Farrah, okay.
Right about here.
Okay.
I was
yes. Hi, yes, and a little sister, too.
Aubrey Rebs.
Oh, you're Aubrey Rebs. Okay. All right.
Chloe.
Okay.
We're here for Mario LeGrand.
Okay.
You must be his mom.
Yeah.
I can see it.
Yes. Okay. And who are you?
Mr. Richards.
Yes, Mr. Richards.
I'm here for all of you.
Yes.
I'm here for all of you.
Yes.
You all did a wonderful job.
Yes. Zoe Vitello.
Zoe Vitello. Okay, all three of you back there?
No.
Okay.
I'm grandfather Melissa Adams, or Mattis Adams.
Wonderful. All right. I'm glad you're jury for your service today. Court is adjourned. All right. Congratulations. Give them a hug, and you're going to thank them for coming here today. Okay? Okay? All right, you guys, come on. Let's get a picture.
Stop recording.